Gus O'Brien here for Music Express. Today we are in Nashville, Tennessee, talking one-to-one with an exciting hip-hop string duo called Black Violin. Speaking for all of our Music Express viewers, we are excited to learn all about this amazing combination. Hip-hop and strings, who would have thought? First, let me introduce you to our viewers out there. Students, please meet Will B and Kev Marcus.
Good to meet you.
I understand that the two of you have played together since high school. Tell us about your school music experience and how you got paired up.
We met in high school, first day of high school. We were stand partners in orchestra class. I was first chair, he was second chair.
It's not true.
It's definitely the truth. We were both violists at the time. And that's how we met. And, you know, every day, we second period, we'd play Bach and Beethoven. But it was just all about, you know, what we were doing on our off time, which was just listening to hip hop and being inspired by hip hop, but taught classical music. So that's kind of how we came up with it.
You started playing music by classical composers like Bach, Beethoven, and Mozart. So how did you make the transition to hip hop?
Well, I think it was something that was just always in us. It was very organic, you know, it just happened naturally because we were hip hop before we were classical, you know, so for us to put the two together was just something that naturally happened, you know.
I heard you got your big break by winning Showtime at the Apollo. What is Showtime at the Apollo and what was that like?
Showtime at the Apollo is like the longest lasting competition show. It's basically where American Idol got their idea from, you know? It's the toughest crowd in the world. I mean, they will boo you off stage if they don't like what you did, and it's embarrassing. But, you know, it was nerve-wracking trying to going on Apollo, you know? Just, you know, because we've watched it growing up, so going on Apollo, we were just very nervous. Like, man, we're gonna get booed. We got these violins, you know? But luckily, we won the whole thing, so we didn't get booed. So it was an amazing experience. I mean, the legends have performed on the stage, from Michael Jackson to James Brown to, you know, just name it. They've rubbed that log. So it was just an incredible experience.
You've said that after a performance, you want your audiences to leave feeling better about themselves. How do you accomplish that?
Well, you know, our show is really about unity. It's about entertaining, educating, and inspiring all at the same time. Not being preachy, but, you know, having a good time, like, you know, get up, dance, and it's very unifying. So it's a kind of show that, you know, it's a, you know, five-year-old kid or a 70-year-old woman can sit next to each other and get up and dance, and they have something in common. So it's just a very wholesome, feel-good kind of show, but it's also gonna show you things that you've never seen before, or, you know, probably show you things that this violin can do that, you know, people didn't think was possible. So it's, we like to think of it as an entertaining, educating, and inspiring, mind-blowing experience.
Who are your musical inspirations?
So many. I mean, as far as classical, I like a lot of dark composers, like Shostakovich, one of my favorite composers, Hindemith. And as far as hip hop, and just in general, I like a lot of old music. You know, anything that was made in the 70s, I'm just drawn to. You know, I think a lot of those, a lot of music at that time had a lot of strings in it. So I think that's one of the reasons why I'm drawn to it. You know, Stevie Wonder is a huge inspiration to me. You know, Marvin Gaye, obviously, just a legend. Bob Marley, you know, another huge inspiration. And anything to me, anything that kind of tells a story and it has a message to it, I'm always drawn to musically, you know.
Yeah, I mean, same. Like, you know, my composers are more like Bach and Beethoven. I love chamber music, so I like anything Beethoven ever did, anything Brahms ever did. You know, as far as chamber music is concerned, it was, you know, that's kind of my bread and butter. Same, you know, Stevie Wonder, definitely Bob Marley. In the hip-hop world, I grew up on, like, Jay-Z and the Fugees and Lauryn Hill and, you know, Common. I grew up on that kind of stuff. And I always like positive hip-hop, you know, with musical melodies. That was what I was always drawn to hip-hop-wise. And, you know, I just like things that just, you know, make my head nod, but it's just very beautiful at the same time. And that's the music I'm drawn to, and this kind of music that we make.
If you could play music with anyone in the world, who would it be?
Man, that's a
like someone
question.
Alive. Like, I mean,
breathing, living.
I mean, Stevie Wonder, right? We can agree, Stevie Wonder. For
absolutely.
Sure. Like, you know, of the artists that are alive, I love to play with Stevie Wonder. I mean, I just musically, he's a genius, and he was before his time.
Another one is Kendrick Lamar. I think he's an amazing performer. He really performs in a way that is just almost like he's in a different world. And that's kind of how we, you know, that's kind of like how we approach our performances. So he's definitely another person that I would love to be on stage.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, and then, you know, I'll throw Beyonce in there. She's like the best performer of our time. I really feel that. So I'll throw her in there because, you know, she is that performer of our time. And every time I see her, I mean, musically, for sure, she's great. But performance, I've never really seen anything like that. So I'll throw her in there as well.
I know you are instrumentalist, but I hear singing on some of your recordings. Who is that and how did you make that transition happen?
I don't know, this guy named Will B.
It's pretty crazy. Good, this guy.
You know, it's funny. It's something that just kind of grew and it became this thing. And I remember just a few years ago, I had to like consider myself a singer now because it's like I'm singing a lot on stage. Because before it was just, you know, I'm a church boy, so I was singing in the choir, you know. The drummer, if he missed a night, a church service, I would pick up the drum and start playing. Yeah. So I was that kid, you know, always picking up stuff. So we're always performing, we're always on stage. So, you know, it allowed me to grow into the singer that I am. And I'm still growing, you know what I mean? So, you know, it's amazing. It's one of those things that during our show, you never see it coming. It's almost like a surprise. It's almost like, oh, snap, he could sing, you know? So it's always cool, it's fun.
Who writes your arrangements and comes up with the ideas for songs?
We both do, you know. Sometimes it'll be like we have a violin line, you know, like on our album Stereotypes, there's one song called Shaker, and we took a Shaker melody and wanted to kind of mess with it a little bit. And so that song kind of started with the idea of like, okay, let's take this melody and kind of flip it on its head. Mm-hmm. Then there's other songs that like Stereotypes, like the title song of our album, it's like that song we started off in the studio, the two of us and our good friend DJ Infamous, and we made that song just from scratch. And musically, I mean, it took maybe an hour, you know, to record it, create it, everything. So certain songs just kind of come about certain ways. But arrangement-wise, we do most of the arrangements. Sometimes we get other guys to come in and do some, you know, string arrangements for us to, like, really, like, take it to another level. But, you know, for the most part, it's just sort of like what we're feeling at that moment and what this project is to represent.
Do you have any words of advice for our listeners who are struggling with practicing their instruments?
You know, what I would say is, you know, when you get home, just take your instrument, open up the case, and put it on your bed. You know, you're going to walk by it enough times, and hopefully you'll have an urge to pick it up. Just try to discover more about your instrument and what you're doing. I think once you understand more about what you're doing and the instrument that you're playing, I think you have more of appreciation for it, and I think you'll want to practice more, you know?
Yeah, and to add to that, like, I'll tell you, like, I've been playing violin, viola for 25 years, and I never, ever liked practicing when I was younger. Never, ever, ever. I just kind of got good because I was in the orchestra, and, you know, I played enough that I got good. It wasn't really until middle of high school to college where I started, like, kind of dabbling in hip-hop and dabbling in producing music, and then I could turn the violin into mine. Like, I felt like for many years, this instrument was my mother's, and it was my teacher's, and it was like everyone around me. But then it became a moment in college where I really wanted to, you know, mess with hip hop and bring hip hop with the violin. And then I practiced constantly because I wanted to do something different with it. I wanted it to speak for me. And I think any kid that we ever talk to that's ever talking about practicing, you know, it's hard to practice something that's not yours. You know, if it's Mozart, if it's Beethoven's, if it's your mom's, if it's your teacher's, then, you know, practicing is a chore. Whereas if it's yours and where you, like, open up your violin case, like, you know, like he said, open up your case and you walk by it enough times and you pick it up and you play that Taylor Swift song or you play that Drake song or you play whatever it is that is you, you know, it brings you further into this instrument and it makes it yours and you will never put it down if you can pick it up and, you know, as soon as I give you this, you play Gus, whatever Gus is at this moment. You'll never put it down because it's now a way that you can express yourself.
Kev, Will, could you play something for our Music Express viewers? I know they would love that.
Sure. Well, we were just talking about just kind of playing what you feel. So we're going to, some people call it freestyling. We'll just improv a little bit for you. We'll try doing it sitting down. Can you? let's see. Thank you.
Thanks so much for talking with us today, Will and Kev. You are truly amazing musicians and have inspired many students today to keep practicing and explore every possibility by looking at things from a different perspective.
Thank you.
I'm Gus O'Brien, one-to-one with Black Violin. Be nice to your teacher, and we'll see you next time here at Music Express.